reports on the performance, it seems like the result didn't really match your display.
No, I think we fell just a little bit short. We certainly felt it in the legs in and around the 70th, 75th minute. And I think as the game wore on and it became a bit more open at 1-1, certainly, they did look a bit more of a threat than we did going forward. So it was probably inevitable that they were going to get a chance. And it's just the way it goes, isn't it? Unfortunate that Rees made a slight error. But, you know, we've made errors all across the pitch over 90 minutes and they go unnoticed, whereas the goalkeeper makes one and it's quite big noticeable. But, yeah, look, credit to her. She's kept us in the game, some great saves early doors. So, yeah, it's just a disappointment.
You must be really pleased with the first half performance and how you responded to that early setback from the penalty, because really going into half time you should have been one or two goals up.
Yeah, definitely. The first half performance, we knew that they would come out and try and play their game, and we knew that if we pushed them back we would make chances, you know. It's unfortunate she's given the penalty away, but we talked about that. We talked about going 1 or 2 nil down early doors and how we would respond, and you know, and the girls did just that, responded well, you know. 5 minutes in, there's still 85 minutes left of the game to go, so anything can happen as such. But credit to the girls, they stuck to the game plan right up until that 90th minute. You know, we knew what we were trying to do and we executed it really well.
Just run us through your goal, the free kick.
To be honest with you, I'm lucky I was taking it, because Jazz, who's on the bench today, normally takes all our set pieces. I'm just going to hit it as hard as I can, straight down the middle, and just hope for the best. And yeah, his power has gone past her more, I think. I don't know if she's seen it or not seen it, but the second one was rubbish. That's normally my standard. But yeah, happy to have seen it go in. And I think it was just what we deserved, really. We didn't deserve to be 1-0 down. Dumps has made the save on the penalty. It's just gone under her, so she was close to that. But yeah, it gets us in the game and it's game back on then.
And what does it feel like to score here at St James's Park, actually for a whole, for the ladies to play here as well?
The whole day has been fantastic. You know, I've been up since the crack of dawn, excited, just like all the other girls, and probably just like the Buckland girls, to be honest with you. It's a great occasion. We had everything covered, from media to food and drinks to you know, programmes and all sorts. And I can only thank the club and the trust for everything that they've done for the ladies team. And hopefully this is one of many more games that we can play out here. So yeah, I'm really delighted. To score here is great, is a great feeling. You know, one I'm always going to remember, but it's just a shame it wasn't a goal and a winning scoreline for us. But yeah, I'm very happy.
One of the other pleasing things of the day must be the turnout today. 606 people came to watch you. That's a good turnout.
Exactly, and it just shows that down this way there's so much opportunity for girls and women to play football. And I think if it's advertised and is put out there into the wider audience, and we can attract numbers. Unfortunately, you know, with the weather being as rubbish as it is, women don't have the luxury of playing on lovely surfaces like this, so our games are off quite often, so that probably detracts people coming out and stuff like that. Standing on a side of a park pitch is probably not as glamorous as it is sitting in St James's Park. So yeah, you know, we're here, we had 606. I can only thank every single one of them that's come out today and supported both teams. And yeah, safe trip home.
Excellent. Thank you, Abby.
You're very welcome. Thank you.